Hello, it's PingPoint. In this video, we'll talk about binary multiplication. For binary multiplication, we follow the same process as multiplying two decimal numbers. Let's say we want to multiply 6 by 5, which in binary will be 1 1 0 by 1 0 1. 1 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0. 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1. And 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1. To go to the next row, we need to add 0 and move to the second digit and multiply. 0 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0. 0 multiplied by 1 is equal to 0. 0 multiplied by 1 is equal to 0. To go to the next row, we need to add 2 zeros. Then move to the third digit and multiply. 1 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0. 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1. And 1 multiplied by 1 is equal to 1. As you can see, binary multiplication is much simpler than decimal multiplication. The multiplier contains only zeros and ones, so each multiplication step produces only zeros or a copy of the multiplicand. If your multiplier is zero, obviously you will get zero, because any number multiplied by zero is equal to zero. And if your multiplier is one, you get exactly the same thing. 1 1 0, like this one, you have 1 1 0 and another 1 1 0. Then let's proceed to addition. 0 added to 0 is equal to 0, plus another 0 is equal to 0. 1 added to 0 is equal to 1, plus another 0 is equal to 1. 1 added to 0 is equal to 1, plus another 0 is equal to 1. 0 added to 1 is equal to 1, and bring down 1. So our product is 1 1 1 1 0. We can verify our answer by converting the given and the product to decimal. This column is for the ones, and this is for the twos. Next is 4 4 8 and 16. Then add numbers with ones. For the multiplicand, we have 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. And for the multiplier, we have 4 plus 1 is equal to 5. And 6 multiplied by 5 is equal to 30. Then our binary product should be 30. We have 16 plus 8 is equal to 24, plus 4 is equal to 28, and plus 2 is equal to 30. Then we can say our answer is correct. For our second example, let's multiply 1, 0, 1, 1 by 1, 0. 0 multiplied by 1 is equal to 0. 0 multiplied by 1 is another 0. If your multiplier is 0, just fill this row with zeros. So this is 0 and this is 0. To go to the next row, we need to add 0. 1 multiplied by 1, 0, 1, 1. Then we're gonna get exactly these 4 digits. So we have 1, 1, 0, 1. Then proceed to addition. We have 0 added to 0 is equal to 0. 0 added to 1 is equal to 1. 0 added to 1 is equal to 1. 0 added to 0 is equal to 0. And bring down 1. So our product is 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. To check our answer, we have 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. Then add up numbers with 1s. For 1, 0, 1, 1, we have 8 plus 2 plus 1 is equal to 11. And 1, 0 is equivalent to 2. And 11 multiplied by 2 is equal to 22. And our binary product is equal to 16 plus 4 is equal to 20 plus 2 is equal to 22. So our answer is correct. Every time you multiply any binary number by 1, 0 or by 2, all you need to do is add a 0. We have multiplicand 1, 0, 1, 1 and multiplied by 1, 0. The product is 1, 0, 1, 1 and 0. So all you have to do is add a 0. Like for example, 1, 1 multiplied by 1, 0 or 2, the answer is 1, 1, 0. 1 multiplied by 11 is equal to 11 and bring down 0. Then we have 1, 2, and 4. Then add up numbers with 1. So this is 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. And 1, 0 is equivalent to 2. And 3 multiplied by 2 is equal to 6. And for our product, 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. So any binary number multiplied by 1, 0, or 2, just add 0. The same concept as in decimal numbers. Every time you multiply a number by 10, all you have to do is add a 0. Like for example, 15 multiplied by 10. The answer is 150. All you have to do is add a 0. 1 multiplied by 15 is equal to 15 and just bring down 0. Now let's try a harder example. 1 1 0 1 1 multiplied by 1 1 0 1. 1 multiplied by 1 1 0 1 1 is going to be whatever is on the multiplicand. So we have 1 1 0 1 1. Then add 0 to go to the next row. And 0 multiplied by 1 1 0 1 1 is equivalent to 5 zeros. 2 3 4 and 5. Then you need to add 2 zeros from the right, since our next multiplier is on the third column. Then 1 multiplied by 1 1 0 1 1 is exactly 1 1 0 1 1. Then to go to the next row, you need to add 3 zeros, since our next multiplier is on the fourth column. Then 1 multiplied by 1 1 0 1 1 is exactly 1 1 0 1 1, whatever is on the multiplicand. Then let's proceed to addition. We have 1 added to 0 is equal to 1, added to another 0 is equal to 1, and added to another 0 is equal to 1. 1 added to multiple zeros is still 1. And 0 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus 1 is equal to 1, and plus another 0 is equal to 1. Then 1 added to 0 is equal to 1. And added to 1 is equal to 1, 0. So this is 0 and carry 1. Then coming back down, 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. Then 1 added to 1 is equal to 1, 0. So this is 0 and carry 1. So 0 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus another 0 is equal to 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. Then we have 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. Then 1 plus 1 is equal to 1, 0. So this is 0 and this is 1. Then 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. 1 added to 1 is equal to 1, 0. So this is 0 and carry 1. 0 added to 1 is equal to 1. Then 1 added to 1 is equal to 10. And let's do a quick check in decimal. So we have 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, and 256. Then add up numbers with ones. For our multiplicand, we have 16 plus 8 plus 2 plus 1. 16 plus 8 plus 2 plus 1 is equal to 27. And for our multiplier, we have 8 plus 4 plus 1. 8 plus 4 plus 1 is equal to 13. 3 multiplied by 7 is equal to 21, so this is 1, and carry 2. 3 multiplied by 2 is equal to 6 plus 2 is equal to 8, and 1 multiplied by 27 is equal to 27. Bring down 1. 8 plus 7 is equal to 15, so this is 5, and carry 1. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. So the answer is 351, and we should get the same answer. And for our binary product, we have 256 plus 64. We have 256 plus 64. Then we have plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 and plus 1. So we have plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 and plus 1. We have here 256 plus 64 is equal to 320, plus 16 is equal to 336, plus 8 is equal to 344, plus 4 is equal to 348, plus 2 is equal to 350, and plus 1 is equal to 351. And we got the same answer. So we can say our answer is correct. So that's how you do binary multiplication. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing if you haven't yet and click the notification bell so that you'll be notified on my next video.